Reefing fam, what's up? Fellow YouTubers, March here, Fragbox TV. Today's episode, we're gonna do a vlog update of what's going on in the store. Where to begin? This tank needs a full update video on its own. It went through a lot of trouble recently, and we finally got it dialed back in. I should have recorded more of the issues. What I did instead was kind of resolve the issue and then look back and talk about it in hindsight, which was a little bit too easy. I kind of wish that I shared a little bit more of my struggle with this tank when we were going through the real shit that was going on. But I didn't do it that way. It was pretty bad. It was kind of embarrassing. So like I said, on this channel, I want to show you the good and the bad. This was quite bad. I put the camera down and tried to focus on what was actually going on with the tank rather than recording it and showing off or sharing my embarrassing laziness. But go and watch the other video called Strange Reef Tank Issues that we released about a week ago. It's going to be a couple of videos back explaining exactly what happened with that tank. I saw the comments on this. This was our most expensive Nano Reef. I don't think we got more thumbs down than any other video we've ever done because you guys said that we're kind of copping out, I guess, by not doing it. So you know what? We will continue along that theme for the tank. It's going to still stay as our most expensive reef tank. We're going to change it up in terms of the corals. We're going to go with very nice, expensive, easier to keep corals because it's so small. We're gonna be very selective. I am gonna do an apex on the tank like we talked about. I'm gonna get a trident going and then discuss to you guys how we got a surprise visitor here today. No vlog update is complete without a visit from Fragbox's mom. This is my mom here. Hi. Goodbye, mother dearest. Okay, where were we? One other thing I wanted to mention for this tank here. The addition of this fish here, this is a blue reef chromis. I haven't kept one in many, many years, and it's just a really cool looking fish. I'm really happy with the addition. In the basement, we have 20 green chromis that are getting ready to go into this tank because I've always wanted a nice school of chromi. Is that the word to say it? More than one chromis. Nothing to update on Mr. Diggs. He is the same usual lazy bulldog. This tank over here, I don't know how no one's bought this already. This is a, look, it's telling you, take me home. We just reduced the price by 50 bucks. It's a custom made glass aquarium on this really nice stand. It's just waiting, begging for someone to take it home to be a reef tank. If you're here in the Toronto area, come grab this thing. It is a steal at 400 bucks. It's 400 Canadian. It's quite inexpensive and really nice high gloss white cabinet. The invert system is just almost there. It's almost done. We finally have our little price labels and it's starting to fill up. So it's looking good. We've got the urchins, pin cushions, tuxedos, cowries, serpent stars, different macro algaes, blade algaes, 5 different types of conches, serpent stars. It's filling up really, really nicely. We're gonna start offering mangroves, which will be cool. Red and black varieties, lots of different shrimps, hermit crabs, snails, all the cleanup crew that you can imagine and all the weird shit that you normally don't see, like these really, oh man, these are, I don't like touching them. Spider decorator crabs. They're really cool though. They're creepy looking. This is some of the different and fun aspects of the hobby, is these kind of weird cleanup crew members and reef janitors that you don't typically see. So one of the biggest changes here at the store, I'm always trying to make improvements. So if you've ever not come to the store, let's say you live in the Toronto area and you don't come for 3-4 months, you know that when you walk in here, something is going to be very, very different. During COVID, it gave me a lot of time because the store was closed to kind of do different projects around the store. And I have a list, a mental list basically going at all times for changes that I want to make. So it's constantly evolving. I'm always thinking, how can we do this better? Or how can we do this smarter? It never stops changing in this store. And I'm all about projects and stuff like that. And I think a lot of hobbyists are as well. There's really no finish line with this hobby. Like, if you're into cars, maybe there's a point where you stop. You can't modify much more. If you're into, I don't know, any hobby, for example, sometimes it ends, you know, or, you know, this one, there's just no clear defined finish line. It's just constantly changing, and the store is the same kind of in that sort of respect. So another change we made here are these really cool little numbers. We found this guy on, I think, on Instagram. I don't know, I don't use Instagram. If you've ever messaged us on Instagram, it's Tia or Dylan that's talking to you. I don't know how to hashtag, I don't know how any of that stuff works. I'm old school in that regard. But these little numbers are here to help us really improve our order accuracy. So we're huge on what you see is what you get. If you see on the site any designation that has that, so that when you order, you know, number 8 Golden Hammer, we know with certainty that's the piece you're gonna get in the mail. So that's gonna actually, we're kind of starting in this system here, and then we're gonna prototype that design throughout the whole store, starting with the colonies, mostly LPS, and then moving that same concept over to the SPS frags that we keep in this tank. And if I haven't already mentioned it, I'm in love with fox faces, and they're really nice, and this tank is just looking phenomenal. It was dealing with a lot of hair algae issues, and I'm gonna implement that same strategy from that tank over in this one over here, because we're also dealing with a little bit of, it's not really hair actually, it's like if hair algae and Bryopsis had a love child, a piece of shit hybrid algae that nothing really wants to eat except fox faces. Let me see if I can show you here. It doesn't grow the fastest. Actually, comment below, please, if you know what this is. It's a brownie green. Astrea snails seem to like it. Turbos don't touch it. Trochus don't touch it. The fish absolutely don't touch it. The fish that are in this tank are basically the world's most useless tangs. I don't know how we got lucky enough to conglomerate the shittiest fish in one tank. Like, it looks like they're doing something. I can tell you, these fish are useless. This Tamini, this Scopus, his other Scopus, and that yellow tang do a horrible job at keeping this tank clean. So what I'll do sometimes is take these like kind of dirty rocks or frags, I'll throw them over in this tank, and no word of a lie, within 10 minutes, the 7 tangs that are in here are an algae destroying army. They just completely devour anything, even Bryopsis, which is one algae that if you read online, people will say tangs don't eat. I can tell you from experience, this yellow coal tang, actually I think there's 2 of them, this guy doesn't give a shit what the algae, this is algae's worst nightmare. This thing will eat anything, including Bryopsis. And that's how you get sidetracked. So anyways, what I was trying to say was trying to implement better order accuracy by using these numbers, and then implementing iPads here in the store. So we're gonna have 3 or 4 of them around the tanks set up so that customers can kind of shop on this while they're in the store. So Matt used to work at another store here in the area that shut down, and this is something they used to do, but it just kind of makes it easy. Oh, I like that, and that's within my price range, and you know, oh, that's number 85, and then you can kind of go over and see it. And one of the things that we do in the store that is kind of uncommon, at least for stores, I don't know if this is how it is where you guys are, but we have everything priced out. So what we're just cleaning the numbers now, you see here they say 30 and 60, we're just cleaning them because they get covered in Coraline, but these are all $10 frags, $20 frags, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 100, and then the colony, same thing. So everything's got a price on it, because I found that some stores, or at least when I was shopping more as a hobbyist, that the price of the coral would change based on the car you drove, which is not right. If you are a brain surgeon or you're a student in debt, I think you should pay the exact same price for every single coral. And unfortunately, I don't know why, any other retail store, that just seems like a normal, obvious thing that goes without explanation. Stuff has prices on. You go into any retail store, the price is going to be the price. For some reason, at least here in this area in Canada, that this hobby, this kind of retail operation is the exception, where the price changes based on the customer. And I've experienced that buying on the hobbyist end. And I don't know if it's like that where you are, but comment below. What are your opinions on stuff like that? Neptune Skylights coming in this week. People that pre-order them, you're gonna get the first batch of them. So you know who you are, you've texted me or emailed me, your lights are on the way. And because of that, we're gonna do a nice little extension. I'm gonna do some cool wraparound shelving of the Neptune. They're always coming out with new products. These guys are growing and expanding. And this is quite a small store. We don't have a lot of room here. It's about 16 feet across and I want to say 40 feet long. So it's jam-packed. We're having to go higher and higher, stuff that's not as common closer to the ceiling, and then grabbing a ladder to take it down. I wish we had a bigger store. We're making the best of this space. So that's really exciting to see that light coming out. We're going to have to give them more room. So one more change, part of this vlog update. It's actually going to be down here in the basement. Maybe not as exciting as stuff that we're changing and doing upstairs, but I'm going to talk to you about it anyways. So I'm going to do a little extension of our sump over here. So we hold not too many corals, some apropora down here under some pretty intense T5 reef bright lighting. Still my favorite sort of lighting for hard corals, SPS, growing and coloring them up. We have this large kind of dead space, you know, right here. It's about seven feet across, and my inner hobbyist is coming out, and I can kind of picture adding more aquariums and water, because that's what my mind naturally does. If I see a space, let's throw an aquarium in there. So we need to put an aquarium here. That's what I've decided. It's going to be 7 feet long, 3 feet wide, very shallow, maybe 10 inches. And the idea behind it is to just be able to hold more coral for growing out, but as well more space to bring in coral so that we can keep upstairs organized. The second thing I'm going to do is get rid of this dinky old little computer in this section here. This is all going to come out, and then we're going to do another nice 7-footer over there tied into our farm system here. And the idea behind this section is going to be to grow out more soft corals and mushrooms, because we have them kind of intermingled here alongside some zoanthids and Monty Cap and a bunch of LPS, and it's just hard to get the right flow and lighting conditions. You see we're using T5 on some and Radeons on the other, so I'm going to do T5 probably on most of this, move the Radeons over to here, and that should be another little fun project. I can show you how I build the stand, how I plumb it, because I think you guys like that sort of video. And then find, oh, look at these, the quarantine fish that are going to go in the display tank. So we haven't lost even one. There's 22 fish in this tank. They look great. I thought I saw something on one of them on the tail, but that could just be nipping, because there's so many. They do tend to fight amongst each other and they kind of figure out a pecking order, but they look really good. I think I'm gonna pull the trigger maybe in a couple days from now and just throw them up into the display tank that's upstairs. Also want to redo this. This needs to get redone. This is our old kind of grow out macroalgae tank, and it's just dirty and outdated, and it's been running like crap for you. Well, it does its job. You know what? Not running like crap. It does what it's supposed to do. It keeps the tank clean and we can grow up macroalgae, but I want a much larger 6-foot macroalgae section with partitions and baffles to better organize and separate the algae from one another. And you saw in the other video, I was talking about the crappy wiring, really bad, embarrassing wire, like really bad. I mean, if 10 is the worst, this is 15. It's really bad. So as I set up that new aquarium over there, I'm gonna take this opportunity and time to really do the wiring nicely. I mean, organized and just, you know, you ever see wiring on an aquarium that's just sexy? Maybe that's not the right word, but if you're a hobbyist and you're watching this, you know what I mean. Just to see super clean plumbing and wiring, there's something very satisfying about it. This is like one of my best attempts here, and it's still not that great. It's hard. You know what? When you're running a shop, you have so many plugs and drains and returns and pumps that it gets tricky. I don't know how many plugs we have running in the store and how many pieces of equipment. I've showed this in a couple other videos. It's a lot going on. This is organized chaos. I more or less know what everything in here is, but I don't know how you would organize something like this. You know, it's just a lot going on. There's got to be like 50 something different plugs running off 6 different breakers. It's a little bit of a mess, but I'm gonna try my best on this system to set an example for what reef aquarium wiring and plumbing really should look like. That's about it for today's vlog update here in the store. It is July of 2021, so in this hobby, this hobby is definitely seasonal. That's what I've noticed over the past 10 or so years in business. We do triple, quadruple the volume we do in walk-in customers and sales and online shipping in the winter months than what we do in the summer months. And I think it's just part and parcel that people are outside and enjoying the outdoors here in Canada. We have 4 or 5 glorious months, and then we have a terrifying Baltic cold winter wonderland. So people really spend these months, I think, outdoors, and the aquariums kind of take a back seat. But the nice thing about that is the store is not as busy, so it kind of gives me the opportunity to do these projects and do these fun ideas that I have to improve the store. But if you guys actually have any ideas for improvement, hit us up in the comments. Some of the best ideas that we've implemented here in the store have been through customer feedback. We always have open ears and we appreciate any feedback at all, good, bad, neutral, whatever you guys want to say. We do look at the comments. But that's it for today's episode of Fragbox TV. If you like, oh, no touchy-touchy, Mr. Hammer, that's not good. Too close to the mushroom coral. What? Did the mushroom coral hurt the hammer? No, maybe it just closed up. Sorry, getting distracted. Yeah, if you like the content, hit the subscribe button. You know where it is. We strive to do a video every single day of the week. That's 7 reef-related videos for every day. It's unheard of. It's a lot of work. We love doing it. Thank you very much for watching this episode of Fragbox TV.